Trust me when I say this. This is going to be the most easiest egg drunken noodles you're ever going to make. Take a wok, full flame. When it's nice and hot, add the oil and add lots of garlic. Okay, no ginger, only garlic. Now we're going to add some Thai red chilies, which are super spicy. So it's totally up to you how much you want to add, and sliced onions. Break the onions up and let this entire thing just stir fry for a good 2 to 3 minutes. We want the onions to be soft. We do not want them to brown up totally. Here I've added some green chilies just to bring in a little bit of extra color. And in goes bok choy stems. I'm using bok choy. You can use spinach. If you're using spinach, you can add it at the end, not now. Now this is going to fry for a minute or so, and everything is going to cook together, including the garlic, the chilies, the onion, and the bok choy stem. Now the protein, the choice of protein I'm adding is chicken mince. You can add just chicken pieces, you can add shrimps, you can add no fish, because fish will break up in this entire process of stir frying. Now chicken mince gets a little tough to break up or get into finer pieces when it's just oil and it's just heat. You have to add a little bit of water. This is my secret style of making it. Give it a try, you'll realize the difference. Once you add water, one thing that surely happens is the chicken mince stays moist. Otherwise, chicken mince, if you over fry and cook it, it gets super dry. So what the water ensures is that it breaks up into very, very fine pieces, and secondly, it remains moist. So now that this is all cooking up together, we are going to add the next thing, which are the cooked egg noodles. Traditionally, drunken noodles are made with rice noodle sheets, which are freshly made. I didn't get the time to make it, nor are they available fresh in the market. It's either in Singapore or the Thailand markets where they're easily available. Here I have used plain egg noodles. I'm going to toss everything together. Now I've prepared a sauce. The recipe will be mentioned. I do not believe in adding the entire sauce at one time. I'm going to be using up the entire sauce eventually, but little by little. So one spoon went at the center, another spoon went around the wok. I'm going to give it a good mix. I'm going to let that color and the sauce mix in with the entire noodle stir fry. Otherwise, when you pour everything at once, there's only a patch of noodles that gets the color, the rest don't. And I really, really believe in pouring it little by little. Now, balance of the sauce is going around the edges. Edges, basically, when the sauce touches the wok, it really gives a good flavor out because the wok is super hot. So now I'm just stir frying everything together. Noodles are cooked, the meat is cooked, everything is cooked. Now in goes in for color, which is red peppers, optional, but I like to add them, Thai basil, and lots of bok choy leaves. Cook everything together. This is not going to take more than 2 minutes. All the leaves are going to wilt, and this dish, trust me, is the best you're ever going to be eating. It is very easy. It's a family meal. As I said, protein choice could be chicken mince or just regular chicken, which is cut up into cubes. And you can add prawns if you want. So this dish is super duper easy and delicious. I've taken out the noodles. Now in the same wok, I've added a little bit extra oil, and I'm adding the eggs. Now the eggs, you have to note, do not scramble them too fast and make it like super fine, like a mince. Otherwise, it's going to mix up with the chicken mince and look the same. I want the egg to look like an egg. So scramble it very lightly. Can you see the folds in the center? I want large chunks of well-cooked egg. Give it a stir, leave it alone for a while again, let it set a little bit, and then again give it a scramble. Do not make it like the Indian style bhurji, where, you know, it's super, super fine. We don't want that. So now just look at the noodles. You can see the egg, you can see the greens, you can see the color of the sauce, which is coated in each and every piece of the noodle. This dish, trust me, is one of my favorites. I really like it. It has to be eaten super hot. Don't let it sit for too long. And even if it does sit, you can just reheat it. It doesn't clump up together. So do give this dish a try. They are called the egg drunken noodles. Okay, why are they called drunken noodles? It's basically, this is what I googled. Apparently the noodle tastes really great at 2 a.m., 3 a.m., 4 a.m. types, where, you know, you're drunk and you're eating them. I guess that's the way. But anyway, you don't need to be drunk to taste these. So give it a try.